Okay, hello, welcome my friend, and next I am planning to show you that how to replace this Toyota's engine, what size is 1.8 or 1.6 or even 1.3 liters engines, this water pump. And water pump looks like here, and then I continue. Okay, and then I think that I take these all drive belts away, and it happens easily so that I lift up this engine and then we can look those belts closer. Okay, and here we have this water pump, and first I need to take that belt away, and it starts so that I open these alternator bolts first in here. Okay, and first bolt is this bolt in here, and it is like 12 millimeter, 1-2 millimeter, and I use my tool, and I open this bolt, because this is like locking bolt, and now it's free, good, now I have rotated about 10 times, and then I need to open this next bolt, put this in here, and now it's like it is different sides, it is 1-4 like 14 millimeter socket, and it fits in here. And now let's look that can I open that, because this is more tight bolt. Let's look what happened. Can I open that now? Yes, I managed to open. I rotate that so much that this is loosened. Okay, now when this is loosened, I can do next thing that I can start to rotate. I can start to loosen this belt, and there is a situation that in here, when we look in that side, there is that bolt, and now I need again this 12 millimeter, 1-2 millimeter socket, and it fits in here. And then I start to move that, and in same time I check that how much this belt became looser. And then this is like this direction. In that way, and when I move that, this belt this direction, in down rotation is here. And then this belt became loosened, and about 20 times, and now this is loosened, and then I can take my hand in here, and maybe I can take this belt, not yet, even a bit more, open, like 20 times more. And now this alternator is moving in here, then maybe not yet, I need more adjusting, and this is this tricky part, because I need to move that like 50 times is my shock. Okay, how about now I think that now we have chance. Okay, now this belt is free. Okay, and it is first belt, and then I rotate my engine in here, and we can see that then I need to take this next belt away. Okay, and then we need to open this crankshaft pulley bolt, and this bolt is very difficult to open. And please look my video that how to open crankshaft pulley bolt, because this is extremely tight. Now I was lucky because this was already open, but this is very difficult to open. And then I am planning to take this timing belt out and we continue. Okay, and there is then this crankshaft feel, and especially this central bolt. And this bolt is maybe the most tightest bolt in engine, and there for that job opening we need 17 millimeter socket, and then this bar, actually a little bit longer bar. And then there is first issue that when I start to rotate that, I notice that hey, this crankshaft wheel is moving. And now there is situation that for that purpose Toyota, they have made in here two holes that we can insert in here this Toyota specific tool. But now because I don't have that tool, I show that what kind of tool we have to do by self. It is like modification tool. And let's go to look that tool building next. Okay, and what and how to do that tool? First we need some kind of metallic pipe and that kind of support bar, and I found excellent pipe because there was already those holes. Otherwise, if we don't have this suitable metallic pipe, for thickness is by the way 2 millimeter. This must be a little bit thicker plate, steel plate, and note this is steel, no any plastic or wooden, because they can go broken. And otherwise we need to do holes in here, and this length is something like little bit like 4 feet and like 1 meter and 20 centimeters, 1.2 meters. And this is quite long metallic bar, and then I have cut also smaller bar, and this is like 1 feet, like 30 centimeters. And then we need couple of bolts, standard bolts and nuts, and here I have also a couple of nuts, and actually we need at least 3 nuts, and they can be something like that size and distance about 2 something like 3 inches 6 to 7 centimeters, and thickness is like 1/2 inches, like 5-6 millimeters. And how to then assemble this tool? This is that end area, and there is this second area, and first bolt we need to install in that way, and it should be striked. This has been damaged a little bit, but I need to bend that back, and we install first bolt in here, what is a little bit longer. Its length is at least this something like 4 or 3 inches, like about 10 centimeters, and it's first one, and then I insert that my smaller bar in that distance, what is something like 30 centimeters in that point, and then there must be holes, because I install this one bolt what is in here in that position. I install it is in here in that way, and then we need small plate in there, and then nut, and then I fasten that in that way, and now we have this tool is almost ready. And then and actually these things must be in same line, and that's I need a little bit move that more away, because it must be a little bit more far away in that position. Okay, now they are in same line. This is must that they are in that position, and then I go back in here. Now this tool is ready, and then this final third bolt it becomes in here, and now this our tool is ready, and these bolts goes to this crankshaft wheels holes, and let's go to install then this in this wheel. Okay, good. Okay, and here is this our crankshaft puller feel, and idea is that there is two holes in here. There is this my tool, and firstly, this first bolt goes in there. It is good to insert deeper, and then this my specific bolt, what fits just in there in that way. And then there was so great idea that I can even fasten that bolt, because there was it was so suitable that when I take 17 millimeter socket, I can fasten that in that way. Okay. Now this is quite fine in there. And if this is not enough durable, we can insert in here better bolts. But this is the idea. And then I have this opening socket, 17 millimeter, what fits in here central. In that way, and then note, this is tight bolt, and that's I need in so long this bar, and then in that bar it need to be long, and then when situation is that, I can start to open that so that I only start to rotate that in this way, and I keep one hand in here, note in this lower area what I am doing. Look in here, I have one hand in here, that, and second in here, and then I move that in this way. And this bolt is tight, but now I have already managed to open that, because I worked a little bit before, but this is tight, and in some position we can insert that so that this metallic bar takes contact in some body area. Or if we have assistant who, if this is difficult to open, we can ask that some of our friends keep that in hand, and then we rotate that opening bolt in that way. And now this bolt is free. And then there is option what I made, that when this crankshaft feel it moves. This feel moves really easily when this bolt is tight. I inserted that my tool in that position, and then it takes this metallic contact in here in that position. Okay, but now this bolt is free, and then I can open this crankshaft puller feel bolt, and this is important. Next, I think that I a little bit hammer that feel and it opens. Okay, and now when this central bolt is free, this crankshaft puller feel should opens quite easily. But now it is a little bit tight, but I have hammer and I carefully hammer that in here. In here, then. And it moves already. In that part and also. Okay. And I think that I can use also some other tool. Okay, and this crankshaft puller feel open so that I have hammer, and then I bend that in here a little bit and in back area, and I move, and now it opens. Okay, good. And then we continue. Okay, and then I need 10 millimeter socket that I open this cover bolts in here, all cover bolts. they are a little bit rusty, but I can open those. And then when I have opened those, I can use my electric Hitachi wheel driver. And this is so easy and fast. Look how easily and fast and this bolts opens. And then there's next one. Good. There's next. This is a little bit tight. This is fine. And then here. And then in here. Okay, and soon this all bolts are open. Okay, and now all bolts are free, and then I can lift that cover out and maybe next cover, but then I need to open this water pump fill. Okay, and now I have right tools and I need longer bar, and there is 10 millimeter socket in here, and then this my metallic bar, and I insert that in here, and then I press and I break that my feel, and then in same time I take my that tool, and now I can open these bolts when I first break using that screwdriver, and then when I open this, a little bit difficult, but when now it opens good. In here, that this nut opens, excellent. Then I can take that bolt away. And here is this bolt. But this is a little bit difficult to open, but in that way I can open these bolts. And next I take all of these bolts away, and then we can continue. Okay, and now all bolts are free, and then I can take this water pump cover away, and same way I can open that cover, and then also this one, but it is stuck, and I use my tool that I can move that. A little bit stuck in here. Carefully. Now this part opens. And now timing belt is in free there. Okay, and then I take this timing belt away. And there is idea that I need this 10 millimeter socket. And there is bolt. And I open that bolt first in that way, and I take this tensioner, I loosen this my tensioner bolt, that one in here, and then I take this my bolt away, and then carefully I remove the tensioner, and then timing belt is in here free, and that disc also, and now timing belt is free. Okay, and there is then this tensioner and tensioner spring also. Okay, good, and then we can continue. Okay, and then when I am taking this water pump away, I need then this 12 millimeter socket that I open here, this one, and that one both in that way. They are not very tight. They are very easy to open. Easy way. And then I rotate this bolts away using my fingers. And there is first bolt. And then in here the second. And these are 12 millimeters similar bolt. And there is this third one. There's third bolts. And then there is a couple of those 10 millimeters. I have here 10, like 10 millimeter. And I need a little bit longer bar, that these are easy to open. There is that one, and that one. Now it seems that this my water pump is free, and I can hook in here. And there is then this next part. What I need to do is that there are those clamps. That I have to take these clamps away, or then open these two bolts in here. And I will do that next. Okay, and then this my water pump replace continues, and then I notice that I need to take, there are two bolts in here, what we can look. Those two bolts, one and two, and I need to take those bolts next out. Let's do that. And there is our these target bolts, and they are 12 millimeters. And I insert my tool in here, and then I open these bolts. They are actually nuts. There's first nut and then second, it is also easy to open, and there's now I try to remove that my, and there's one 10 millimeter bolt left, and now I need 10 millimeter tool, this oil stick. Now this is free, and now oil stick is free, and then I can move that, and now this little, I have to move, bend a little bit that my oil stick, and then this water pump is free in here. Okay, and in that way we can replace that oil pump, and of course, water pump. And then I like to show that how we can open these bolts next. Okay, and then these water pumps, 10 millimeter nuts opening. There's my 10 millimeter tool, and I open that bolt in this bolt in here. And next one is in here, and it is also open. And final one is in here. And now I only hit that. Now it's free. And then I use my Hitachi driver, and I open this bolts fast. And that way. And now this water pump is free. And there is that kind of gasket, what belongs in here. And now we can see that water pump in here, inner area and in that area. Okay, and then when we install these things back, remember to install new gasket or gasket glue, and then also in here new gasket and gasket glue, and also in that area in here gasket. Okay, and that kind of information, and thank you for watching that video. Okay, and now there is a situation that in that step I lift up a little bit that engine that I can insert that timing belt. And here is my new timing belt, and in that hole I need to lift up that I can insert that belt through that thing, and then I carefully, and now we have to be so carefully that we don't rotate anything of these metallic fields and these things, because now they are in this position. And then when this is in fine in here, we go to look then this lower area, because this must be in that position. Cool, excellent. And then we go to look that down area next. Okay, and then when we are going to insert this tensioner in down, it's good to lift down this car engine, because now it is a little bit up, and for that I lift this my engine down in there next. And it is easier to work in here down area. Okay, and now when we have this new timing belt, first I insert that in here this down area. In that position. And now I remember that I need to do one thing, because I have these markings in here. I need to go to mark that my new belt in same way. And let's go to do that next. I missed that. Okay, and now engine is a little bit up, because this is my carrying belt. Lift that up, and there is my new belt, and there is my markings in this upper one, and this lower markings, and then I insert my belt carefully in here, and there is this my upper mark in that position, and now it's easy to insert this my belt in same position in that way, and then in central position in that wheel. Note that it must be in central. Excellent, it is there, and look, now there are those white lines are. Okay, and then we go to insert this lower area, and for that it good to insert that belt in so that it goes easily in here down. Okay, and then also check that and now do not rotate that wheel, and it must be, we have to handle that really carefully. Okay, that way, and that looks also good. Okay, and then we go to look that lower area next. Okay, and now we are in that position, and I take a little bit more light that we can see that there was this my white marking what goes in here, and that white marking goes in here, and then in here up one in that position there is then this spring support pin in there in that part, in that this position goes this support pin and spring, and here is I start that my job so that I install first this tensioner, and I start my this job so that I insert first this spring, that part, this part in here, and I insert that firstly in this locking position. And then note that there is a specific hole in this pin. Remember, this is important. Let's go to look that. Because if we if we do miss in there, there is, when we look in that side, we can see that there is this small this in there, just in this bolt. When we look, there is small this hole where this pin must go. Remember that. This is important. The spring must go in that hole. Okay, and then, good. Looks good. And I do that again. I take my this part. And then we can feel that when this spring is this position. Okay, now it's in this position, and then I insert that spring. There is this, sorry, not the spring, this tensioner in that hole. Look, there is this hole in this my thumb here. It must be in there, and then this upper area, there is this bolt place, and then we check that is the spring okay. Okay, it looks good, and then that is okay, and then we can even in final step to test a little bit. But next I take this bolt, this tensioner locking bolt, and it comes in here, and then I rotate that a little bit, and then I need to rotate that. Okay, now it happens that this part moves, and it means that the tensioner spring is okay, but that part is not, and I need a little bit move that in there, and then I check that in that position, and spring is also. And then I fasten this bolt more. Okay, looks good. And then it's good to keep this bolt a little bit loosened, because soon when I am inserting that the timing belt, what comes in here, it comes in that position. In here, and then it's good to move that tensioner using our hands, and then I have to insert this my markings in those pillow area markings, and let's look at how this happens, that how I can do that. And before of that, I check that everything is here fine, and then I start to move that the tensioner in. Actually, I think that I can insert that in here, and then I fasten that central bolt. Yes, this is the trick. Okay, and next I load this tensioner in that the most leftiest position, so that I press my hand in that direction, and then at the same time I fasten that central bolt, and then it is easier to insert that timing belt. And let's look at how I managed to do that. First I move that and in that position, and now I fasten that central bolt. I like lock that, and I open it later. Okay, now it's like locking position. Good, and then it's easier to install this my timing belt in here, in this position. Okay, in that way. Good. Now they are in this right lines in here and in that. This is in here and second in here. And then I noticed that this upper belt opens, and let's go to look that next. Okay, and now when this belt went in different position, I need to insert that white line in that white line, and carefully I insert that here. I check that in what position I can insert that in here. And I check that what is this right way. Insert. I check that these are here, and then I check that now in that position, this my white line should go in here. And let's go to look in that area also. In that area, I can see that now this white line is going just in directly. And then I only need to do so that when this is in that way, that, well, I think that maybe I can a little bit rotate this my camshaft carefully in that position, and then I believe that this my timing chain, and now I move that in clockwise in that way carefully. Now it went in there, then I take a little bit back. Okay, now I check that, is this my white line in right position? And excellent, it is in just in right position. And then I go to this down area to check that. That is my line also in there, in this right position. And then I need to check also that this my timing belt is in just in this central position in here. Okay, and let's go to look then this lower area. Okay, and now we are in this down area, and we can see that now this timing belt is in just in right position when we look those white things. And then it's good to move that timing belt so that it is just in same line as this crankshaft pulley wheel. And now when this belt is in right position, I can open this locking bolt and release. This is important thing that I release now this spring, this tensioner's spring, and it happens so that I open that bolt a little bit, and then we check that what is this belt's thickness, and it seems that this looks good. And now this belt is tight in here, and when this is a little bit loosened, it's good to go to rotate a little bit this upper this camshaft wheel, that this belt moves nicely. And let's go to rotate that, and final step is to then tighten this tensioner bolt in tight position. Okay, and now when this belt is back, it's time to rotate that belt two full turns. Like when there is this one white marking in here, it must be rotate two times. And then this belt, this pre-rotation is ready. And this rotation happens so that we need that tool what fits in that line. And be carefully that you have just suitable tool, no any tongs in here. And then we only rotate in that turn, that this white rotation is in that way. And that I rotate in this way. And then two turns is good amount. And then we check that and now notice that this tensioner is not yet fasten. It is like still free, but this is like pre-rotation. And there is that. Then I check that when we have there is this. Now we have rotate that one turn. And then we have second turn coming in here. Okay. And now I wait that when this white thing. Okay, this was a little bit too big. Okay, and now I think that there is that. I need to still rotate it. Okay, and now this my marking is in here up, and now I have rotated that two total turns. Okay, good. And then I think that I can rotate this my upper wheel in this number one piston position, so that is this. This white paint and that one is in here. And then I test my screwdriver, that is this, yes, there's piston in there, and there's not. Okay, good. Okay, now this is in this fine position, and then we can go to fasten this pillow bolt next. This tensioner bolt next. Okay, and then I fasten this tensioner central bolt. That way, and then I use my Torque French tool, and I insert in here this force in first step 40 newton meters in 40. There is my tool. There is 40 because I think that this bolt must be fasten, and carefully I insert in here, and
and then okay now there's body. Okay, good.
And then we continue. Okay, and then this plate, it becomes in here. Good. And then we continue. Okay, and then I install these plastic covers back in here, and I install those bolts in there. And then when these are back, we continue. Okay, and now when this belt is in ready in there and everything should be fine, we need to do one final test, and it is the stretch test, that when we press in our finger in here, that how much this belt take this stretch. And let's look closer. Okay, and in just in that position where this belt is very long and there is alternator in here, we go to this middle point and then we press our finger a little bit, like a couple of, like in finger press, like 5 kilos was. And then we check that how much this belt takes easily this stretch when we look in here down. And there should be this test result that in just in this central area in here, in that point, and I use my screwdriver in this middle point, it should move something like 0.22 inches or 0.5 centimeters easily, the stretch in that way. And now I think that, and it is central point to this maximum movement, and I think that now this my stretch is just fine and there is no any issues. And let's go to look also in that area what I am meaning, that there is this belt, and then I take a little bit bigger view. This is this final test, that when there is this belt in here, that how much it moves when I carefully press that. And if this belt moves like 1 inch in other ways, then this our belt is too tight. And then if we can't move that anything, then this belt is too tight. Remember, there is not good that this belt is too loosened, and not good that it is too tight. Because if this is too tight, it can go broken, and if this is too loosened, this belt can jump in these feet and teeth in here, and then our engine is in bad condition. But now I think that this belt looks, this is of course more loosened than that one, because there is this constant tensioner, this force. But this looks good. Okay, and this was this final testing, that how much this stretch easily in here. And the amount was 0.5 millimeters in this central line in here. 0.5, it is something like 0.5 millimeters. Sorry, 0.5 centimeters and or 5 millimeters. Or 0.22 inches. Okay, and then we continue. Okay, and now I have installed these covers in here, and now I have this 10 millimeter socket, and I fasten these bolts in here. And there we had all of these bolts where that sides, they look like that, 10 millimeter, what belongs to this plastic covers in here. Okay, good. And then I have fastened these covers, then I will install these spark plug back in here, and after that we continue. Then this is our project. Okay, and now I have installed these plastic covers in here. that area, and now I am installing this cylinder head cover back, and spark plugs are in there, and then I finish these final things, and soon we continue again. Okay, and then I install this crankshaft puller feel back, and there is idea that there is this hole in up, and there is also this pin, and then just in when we look that it goes nicely, we need to only press that in there, and then we can use hammer and little bit hammer it in there, and the final step is that big bolt what we insert in here, and then when I fasten that bolt, the final step is that I fasten that bolt very tight. The force is 100 newton meters is this force. And here is this my torque reference, and there should be newton meters 100 is this force in this torque reference tool, and 17 millimeter socket, and it fits in there, and I can fasten that in here, and let's look that how long I can fasten that. Okay, now it start to move, and that means that now I need to insert that my specific tool in these bolts that I can fasten that. And soon we continue. Okay, and here is this my specific tool. What I insert in here, and then I need to rotate that I can insert that second thing also. Now it's there, good, and then I can start to fasten, and let's look, there is this my tool, it is in there, and then I need to keep my hand in here. And then let's look. Okay, a little bit shorter tool that I can fasten. Okay, I need. And now I have in here this shorter bar in here, and it is easier to fasten. Okay, and let's see that when we hear this click. Okay, good. Now there is force 100. Excellent. And there is my torque reference tool, and now this area is fine. Excellent. And we continue then. Okay, and then I need to install this engine mounting back, and there was those two bolts what goes in here, and next I need to little bit lift that engine up that I can install these bolts in here, and those bolts were in that down area, I can rotate those bolts in there. Okay, and this is my next job then. Okay, and here are those my two bolts, and there is this, then this mounting, and these bolts becomes in here. And I install that in here, and then I rotate this. Then I need to go to that one, and then I insert one bolt. One bolt in here. In that position. Okay. And then I insert these bolts back, and we continue then. Okay, and now I have installed this right mounting and it's in position. And then I continue to next step.